Today we're discussing how low iron, both in iron deficiency anemia, as well as iron deficiency without anemia, can cause palpitations. And by palpitations, I mean those flutters of the heart and general increased sensory sensations of the heart, often creating, you know, this kind of uneasy feeling. You lay on your side and it's like, oh man, feeling it. I think most of us can understand that if iron is low and anemia is present, meaning hemoglobin levels are also low, we can't carry enough oxygen, or the body's desired amount of oxygen, we can't move it swiftly enough to meet the energy demands of the body, and therefore, you know, palpitations or increased heart rate manifest. However, iron has many more roles beyond just, you know, incorporating oxygen and moving oxygen through the body. You know, it's far beyond that. The heart muscle is extremely dense in mitochondria. You may have heard of those. Mitochondria, basically the energy factories of our cells. And these mitochondria require iron as a component of proteins called cytochromes to transport electrons in the electron transport chain. Now, the electron transport chain is the process that creates energy within the mitochondria, allowing the heart muscle contractions to occur and maintain that synchrony that keeps us from thinking about our heart when it's beating 24/7. So muscle cells, like the heart, are also contain the protein called myoglobin. And myoglobin contains iron. And this iron present in myoglobin is essential for enabling this protein to store oxygen within muscle tissue that is then can be used at a later time. So if myoglobin is depleted, muscle cell oxygen will also be depleted. So this too would lead to heartbeat irregularities, flutterings, and sensory system, you know, overload in the heart because of low iron. And on top of this, palpitations and irregular heartbeat can be an effect of the heart rate increasing at rest and with activity as the heart tries to compensate for the reduced oxygen. So with chronic iron deficiency, there is even potential for weakening of the heart muscle. You know, this often manifests as an enlarged heart. If you have a chronic iron deficiency, it's a good reason to, you know, get it taken care of because it's more than just I'm tired. If you're dealing with iron deficiency, it's important to get with a practitioner on board who can, you know, help you get this rectified, get your levels normalized, maintain them, while being sure to address, you know, that underlying issue that is why you're iron deficiency, you know, deficient in the first place. You can also find countless articles, you know, discussing testings, symptoms, signs, strategies for improving iron levels and maintaining them at www.optimizediron.com. Videos, all kinds of stuff, free. So I'm Dr. Matt. Let me know what your iron questions are. I'm happy to answer them, and just put them in the comments. Talk to you guys and gals later.